You're deep underwater, and your submarine's lights reveal a whale skeleton. But it's covered in what looks like colorful, feathery flowers. Except they're not flowers, they're worms. Bone-eating worms. Welcome to the weird world of Osedax, where death becomes life in the most unexpected ways. At first glance, Osedax worms might seem like simple creatures, but a closer look reveals a complexity that defies imagination. These bizarre animals have evolved a body plan unlike any other, perfectly adapted to their unique lifestyle as bone devourers. Picture, if you will, a creature that looks more like an alien plant than an animal. The body of an Osedax worm is divided into three main regions: the colorful, feathery plumes, an elongated trunk, and a root-like structure that burrows into bone. But here's where it gets truly strange. Osedax have no mouth, no anus, and no gut. How then do they feed? The answer lies in their remarkable root system. These roots, which can branch out extensively within the bone, are not just for anchoring the worm. They are living tissue, filled with a network of blood vessels and hosting billions of symbiotic bacteria. These bacteria are the true bone eaters, breaking down the fats and proteins in the bone and providing nutrients to their Osedax host. The feathery plumes that give Osedax their flower-like appearance serve a dual purpose. They act as gills, extracting oxygen from the surrounding water, and they also help in releasing eggs and sperm for reproduction. The trunk, encased in a transparent tube of mucus, connects the plumes to the roots and houses the worm's reproductive organs. One of the most fascinating aspects of Osedax physiology is their method of bone erosion. Unlike many other bone-boring organisms that use mechanical means to drill into hard substrates, Osedax secrete acid to dissolve the bone. High concentrations of an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase in their roots facilitate this process, allowing them to penetrate even the densest whale bones. The size of Osedax worms varies significantly between species and sexes. Females can range from about 1 to 7 centimeters in length, while males are often microscopic. In some species, they're no larger than the size of a few human cells. This remarkable anatomy sets the stage for an equally intriguing life cycle, where the journey from larva to adult is as perilous as it is fascinating. The journey begins when Osedax larvae, tiny and free-swimming, are released into the vast ocean. These larvae, each no bigger than a grain of sand, face an incredible challenge. They must find and settle on the bones of a dead whale in the immense expanse of the deep sea. It's a feat akin to finding a needle in a haystack. Yet somehow, enough of these larvae succeed to keep the Osedax population thriving. Once a larva finds a suitable bone, it undergoes a dramatic transformation. If it lands on an unoccupied area of bone, it will develop into a female. The female Osedax then begins to grow her characteristic root system, burrowing into the bone and establishing her home for life. But what about the males? Here's where the Osedax life cycle takes an unexpected turn. Male larvae that land on or near a female don't develop into full-sized worms. Instead, they remain microscopic, living their entire lives within the tube of the female. These dwarf males, often present in harems of hundreds per female, exist solely to produce sperm for reproduction.
Hey, explorers! Ready to dive deeper into the unknown? We've got exclusive insights waiting for you. Subscribe to our newsletter now, link in the description. Stay ahead of the tide and never miss a discovery. Now, enjoy the rest of the video.
This extreme sexual dimorphism, where females can be tens of thousands of times larger than males, is one of the most pronounced examples in the animal kingdom. Reproduction in Osedax is a continuous process. Females can produce and release hundreds of eggs at a time, which are fertilized by the dwarf males living in their tubes. The fertilized eggs develop into larvae within the female's tube before being released into the water column, starting the cycle anew. Interestingly, some Osedax species break this mold. Osedax priapus, for example, has males that grow to nearly the same size as females and can feed independently. This complex life cycle isn't just a biological curiosity. It plays a crucial role in the larger ecosystem of the deep sea. These bizarre creatures are nature's deep sea recyclers. When a whale dies and sinks to the ocean floor, it creates what scientists call a whale fall. This massive influx of organic material into the nutrient poor deep sea triggers a succession of ecological events that can last for decades. As Osedax bore into the bones, they accelerate the breakdown of these hard tissues, releasing trapped nutrients back into the ecosystem. This process is crucial for the deep sea carbon cycle, helping to distribute organic carbon that would otherwise remain locked away in bone for centuries. But Osedax do more than just recycle nutrients. Their activities create a complex habitat that supports a diverse community of other organisms. The holes and crevices created by Osedax become home to a variety of small invertebrates, from crustaceans to mollusks. This ecological importance isn't limited to a single species of Osedax. In fact, the diversity within this genus is a proof to the adaptability of life in the deep sea. Each species has its own unique characteristics, adaptations, and distribution patterns. Let's dive into some of the most prominent Osedax species, exploring their distinctive features and the fascinating research surrounding them. Osedax rubiplumus, the red-plumed bone eater, was one of the first species discovered and remains one of the most studied. Found in the deep waters off the coast of California, O. rubiplumus is known for its striking red plumes that wave gently in the ocean currents. This species has been instrumental in our understanding of Osedax biology, particularly their reproductive strategies and symbiotic relationships with bacteria. Venturing into colder waters, we encounter Osedax antarcticus, a species adapted to the extreme conditions of the Southern Ocean. In the North Atlantic, Osedax mucoflorus, whimsically nicknamed the snot flower, makes its home. This species, found in relatively shallow waters off the coast of Sweden, challenged the initial belief that Osedax were exclusively deep-sea dwellers. O. mucoflorus has been crucial in expanding our understanding of Osedax distribution and their potential role in shallower marine ecosystems. The Pacific Ocean hosts Osedax japonicus, first described from a sperm whale carcass off the coast of Japan. This species has been pivotal in studies of Osedax life cycles and development. One of the most unusual members of the genus is Osedax priapus, named after the Greek god of fertility. Unlike most Osedax species, O. priapus males grow to a size comparable to females and can feed independently. This species provides a fascinating glimpse into the evolutionary history of Osedax and the development of their extreme sexual dimorphism. In the waters around Antarctica's Deception Island, we find Osedax deceptionensis. This species has drawn attention for its ability to colonize not just whale bones, but also those of seals. This adaptability suggests that Osedax may play a broader role in marine ecosystems than previously thought. Each of these species, along with the many others yet to be discovered or fully described, adds another piece to the puzzle of Osedax biology and ecology. But these worms don't live in isolation. Their very existence depends on complex relationships with other organisms, most notably the bacteria that help them digest bone. One of the most fascinating aspects of Osedax biology is their complex web of symbiotic relationships. At the heart of this web are the bacteria that live within the Osedax's root-like structures, forming a partnership that is essential for the worm's survival in its unique ecological niche. The primary symbionts of Osedax are bacteria belonging to the order Oceanospirales. These microorganisms are not just passive hitchhikers, they are the true bone eaters, possessing the enzymatic toolkit necessary to break down the complex proteins and lipids found in whale bones. The Osedax, lacking a mouth or gut, depend entirely on these bacteria to access the nutrients locked away in the bones they colonize. This relationship is a beautiful example of mutualism in nature. The bacteria gain a protected environment and a steady supply of nutrients from the bone, while the Osedax receive essential sustenance that they could not access on their own. It's a partnership that has allowed Osedax to exploit a food source that few other animals can utilize. But the story doesn't end there. Recent research has revealed that the symbiotic relationship between Osedax and bacteria is even more complex than initially thought. Different species of Osedax host different strains of bacteria, and even within a single species, the bacterial community can change over time or in response to environmental conditions. For example, as a whale carcass decomposes, the chemical composition of the bones changes. Some Osedax species respond by shifting their bacterial partners, hosting different strains that are better suited to breaking down the altered bone composition. This flexibility in symbiotic relationships allows Osedax to continue extracting nutrients from a whale fall long after other scavengers have moved on. These symbiotic relationships haven't just shaped the present-day Osedax. They've been influencing marine ecosystems for millions of years, as evidenced by the fossil record. The oldest known evidence of Osedax activity comes from the Cretaceous period, roughly 100 million years ago. Paleontologists have found distinctive bore holes, characteristic of Osedax feeding, in the fossilized bones of ancient marine reptiles like plesiosaurs and sea turtles. These findings suggest that Osedax or Osedax-like organisms were already well established in marine ecosystems long before the evolution of modern whales. Interestingly, the activities of ancient Osedax may have had significant impacts on the fossil record itself. By breaking down and dissolving bones on the seafloor, Osedax could have significantly reduced the chances of many marine vertebrate remains becoming fossilized. This Osedax effect might explain some gaps in the fossil record, particularly for marine mammals like whales. The fossil record of Osedax also raises intriguing questions about their role in ancient marine ecosystems. In modern oceans, Osedax are part of a complex community of organisms that colonize whale falls in succession. Did similar ecological succession occur around the carcasses of marine reptiles in Cretaceous seas? How did the extinction of these reptiles and the later evolution of whales change these deep-sea communities? As we uncover more about the ancient history of Osedax, ongoing research continues to reveal new insights about these remarkable worms. If you want to dive deeper into the mysteries of the ocean, make sure you're subscribed to this channel.